Well, for 57 years, five C-130 Hercules have been used by our Air Force in many of its most important missions. The aircraft will be replaced by an updated model in 2 years. But until then, they need to remain ready for deployment. Laura Frykberg joined today's training exercise.
A test mission to prove that after almost six decades of use and some recent mishaps, the Hercules can still live up to its heroic name.
It's essentially the type of flying that we do to maintain currents in our crews. And then on top of that, we're going to be conducting airdrop capabilities.
Today, Squadron 40 is practicing how it assists with disaster relief. Taking off from Ohakia, the pilots fly the aircraft as low as 100 metres from the ground, dropping cargo on specific targets, simulating deployments to areas hit by earthquakes or tsunamis where there's nowhere to land.
This is an annual event for the No. 40 Squadron of the Royal New Zealand Air Force. They do it to practice what they would do if they were deployed to a humanitarian disaster in the Pacific region.
The crew successfully conducts the training mission, but perhaps that's no surprise. These Hercules have been used by the Royal New Zealand Air Force since the 1960s.
Turboprops thunder across Wellington when three Hercules transporters worth £4 million arrive at Rongotai.
From peacekeeping missions in East Timor in 1999 to the Balkans refugee crisis the same year, and Afghanistan several times over, including last year to help with the evacuation of Kabul after the Taliban takeover.
We were able to get into Kabul safely, and we were able to pull out, I think we had three flights, so we were able to pull out quite a few people, refugees that we were able to bring back to New Zealand, so it was quite rewarding.
This fleet is soon to be grounded permanently and replaced with newer models in 2024 as part of a $1.5 billion defence spend, ending the long lifespan of an aircraft that's seen its fair share of turbulence on the ground. Laura Frykberg, One News.